Hello students, so today we are going to start with the third chapter of our textbook, which is on Wings of Courage. This chapter is a story of an Air Force Marshal Arjun Singh, who is said to be an icon, which is a symbol of the military, of the Indian military history. And he is also the first and the only officer to attain the highest post of marshal in the Air Force, which is also equivalent to Army's 5-star field marshal, which is, these are the highest posts that you can achieve in the Air Force or in the Army. Okay, so we'll start with his story. So before starting, we'll go through that he was born on April 15, 1919 in Lialpur, which is now known as Faisalabad, Pakistan, which is in Pakistan. He was born before independence, so Pakistan was a part of India. And then he completed his education at Montgomery, which is now known as Sahiwal, which is also in Pakistan. And he was when he was only 19 years old, he was selected for the Empire Pilot Training Course at the Royal Air Force in Cranwell in 1938. And he has flown over 60 different kinds of aircraft. Now, after completing his training, his very first assignment in the Air Force was to fly the Westland Wapiti biplanes, which is the first picture on the right, the topmost picture. Biplanes meaning the planes which have two wings. As you can see in this picture, there are two wings, one above the other. And that was his very first assignment. And he was to fly that plane over the northwestern frontier province, which is also known, which was a part of British India, and now it is a part of Pakistan. And he was in the number one RIAF squadron. RIAF is Royal Indian Air Force Squadrons. Squadron is a group of aircrafts, and it consists of the people who are supposed to fly those aircrafts. After a brief stint meaning a short period of work, after doing a small work in the newly formed number 2 RIAF squadron, he was moved back to the number 1 squadron, and he was made the flying officer of squadron number 1, and he was to fly the Hawker Hurricane. Hawker Hurricane, the picture is on the right, the lower picture is a picture of the Hawker Hurricane. And eventually in 1944, he was promoted to the rank of squadron leader. Now, where before he was a part of the squadron, now in 1944, he was made the leader of the squadron. Okay, in 1994, he led the squadron against the Japanese during the Arkan campaign, where they tried to invade into India. And he also assisted the Allied forces to Yangon, which is all part of the same event against the Japanese. And he had fought so bravely during that campaign that on the spot immediately he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross, which is a position, which is an award which is given to somebody who has shown courage and who has performed bravely. And he was given this award by the Supreme Allied Commander of Southeast Asia, who was Lord Mountbatten at that time. And at that time, Arjun Singh became the first Indian pilot to have received this award. Immediately after that, when he was given the unique honor of leading a flypast of over 100 IAF aircraft over the Red Fort in Delhi. If you would have seen the Republic Day parade or any kind of parades, you've seen those aircrafts that those fly over a particular place, that is known as flypast. Okay, so and he got to lead that flypast with over 100 IAF aircrafts. So that was a big achievement for him, and this happened on 15th August 1947. post that, he was promoted as the wing commander, and later he attended the Royal Staff College at the UK. And immediately after Indian independence, that is after 1947, he commanded Ambala. Ambala is a place where we have an Air Force station, and he commanded that place, commanded the activities in that place as the rank, in the rank of group captain. So he was the group captain in Ambala, and he commanded Ambala during that period. Then in 1949, he was promoted to the rank of Air Commodore, and he took over as the Air Officer Commanding of an operational command. Operational command, which meaning an active command. Air Force Station, which is active, working. And now later, eventually, this position is known as Western Air Command, which is known as Western Air Command. And Singh had the distinction of having the longest tenure as AOC. Distinction meaning he had the honor of being the longest serving AOC, and his duty started in 1949. He served during 1949 to 1952, and then again he served as an AOC in 1957 to 1961. And after his promotion to the rank of Air Vice Marshal, he was appointed as the AOC in C, which is Air Officer Commanding in Chief of an Operational Command. Now, towards the end of the 1962 war, he was appointed as the Deputy Chief of the Air Staff, and he became the Chief of the Air Staff in 1963. And then later he was the overall commander of the Joint Air Training Exercise Shiksha, held between IAF, RAF, Royal Air Force and RAAF, which is the Royal Australian Air Force. He was the commander there. Those are training exercises organized by different countries and different armies and militaries to upgrade their personnel. Then on August 1st, 1964, in the rank of Air Marshal, as in being the Air Marshal, the Air Force, Arjun Singh took over reins of IAF. Took over reins meaning he took control of the IAF. IAF is the Indian Air Force. He took control of the Indian Air Force in a time when the Air Force was still building and was gearing up. That means it was getting ready to meet new challenges. And Singh was the first Air Chief. This is one of his achievements, that till the time he was the commanding officer, he had kept his flying currency. Flying currency meaning till the time he was a part of the Air Force, he kept flying because his flying skills were up to date. He could fly. He was able to fly all kinds of aircrafts. As we saw earlier, that he has flown 60 different types of aircrafts. Okay. And in 1965, Singh led the IAF through Indian Air Force through the war when Pakistan launched its Operation Grand Slam on the town of Akhnoor. When Pakistan tried to invade and capture the town of Akhnoor, there was a bridge there, Akhnoor Bridge. Singh, the Air Marshal Arjun Singh, he led our IAF, he led the Air Force, and which led to the defeat of Pakistan in that war. And looking at his bravery, the then Defense Minister YB Chauhan, he had praised him by saying that Air Marshal Arjun Singh is a jewel of a person. Jewels are precious. So he said that Air Marshal Arjun Singh is a jewel of a person who is precious, who is quite efficient and firm, unexcitable but a very able leader. Looking at his bravery in the Indo-Pakistan War, he was awarded the Padma Vibhushan Award. And this is the picture of him being awarded, him getting the award of Padma Vibhushan from Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. And in recognition of his bravery and his work, his contribution to the Air Force, the Chief of the Air Staff, this position was upgraded and Chief Arjan Singh became the first Air Chief Marshal of the Indian Force. This was a position given to him after looking at his bravery in the Indo-Pakistan War. And as we discussed earlier, that he could fly 60 different types of aircraft from pre-World War II era, which were the biplanes and the Hawker Hurricane that we saw earlier, to the contemporary ones. Contemporary ones meaning the new ones, the very latest ones. These are the pictures of the contemporary aircrafts, which is the first one is the Gnat and the second one is Vampire. And he could also fly the transport aircraft like the Super Constellation. Now, towards the end of his journey, he remained a flyer to the end of his tenure in IAF. That means he could fly aircraft till the end of his tenure, and he retired in August 1969, post which he accepted the ambassadorship to Switzerland, and he became the Lieutenant Governor of Delhi from December 1989 to December 1990. Then the government conferred upon the rank of the Marshal of the Air Force upon Arjan Singh in January 2002, and this made him the first and the only 5-star rank officer in the Indian Air Force. Initially, there was nobody who had received this award, this rank in the Air Force. In Army, they were there, but in the Air Force, he was the first one to achieve this rank. And eventually, this part is not there in your textbooks because it was written before his death, but he died on 16 September to 2017. So, this is the story of Chief Marshal Arjan Singh, about his bravery and about the courageous way that he led our country in various wars, may it be Pakistan, China or Japan. Looking at his bravery, the former Vice Chief of IAF Kapil Kak had said about Arjan Singh that His meaning Arjan Singh's contribution to the Indian Air Force is monumental to the least. Monumental meaning is of great importance and they're very big to acknowledge. And the IAF grew with him. He was the epitome meaning he was the perfect example of military leadership in classical sense, and it is. Therefore, not surprising that he was honored with the rank of Air Force Marshal, which is the highest position that one could achieve, and he was the first one to achieve the rank of Air Force Marshal. And he said that he was not very surprised because he had seen how Chief Marshal Arjan Singh was, and he was not surprised that they had honored him with that rank. Okay, so now your homework is that before your workshop, the workshop warming up exercises that you have before are have examples of homophones and homographs. So quickly I will tell you the difference between homophones and homographs. Homophones are words with different spellings. They have different spellings, but the pronunciation is the same. And the meaning is also different when it is used in different contexts. But the main thing here to remember homophones is that the pronunciation is the same, but meaning and spelling can be different. So for example, C and C. one meaning of sea is the beach or the ocean that we see, and the second meaning of sea is to look, to watch. The meaning of both the words is different. The spelling of both the words is different, but the pronunciation of both the words is same. Such words are called homophones. And then homographs are words with similar spelling. Their spellings is similar, and it may differ. Sometimes it may differ in pronunciation, but they have different meaning. Okay? But they have different meaning. For example, kite. The spelling of kite is the same, and it is also pronounced as kite. Both are pronounced as kite, but the two different meanings are, one is a bird and the other is the kite that we used to fly in Uttaran and such festivals. So your warming up exercise, as you make sentences to bring out the difference between where and where. Now these are examples of homophones. Why? Because they have different spellings, but their pronunciation is same. For example, the first one is where and where. Where is to wear your clothes. The first meaning of where is to put something on. You can say go, you should wear your clothes correctly. And then the second meaning of wear is item, something that you make is wear. So you have to make different sentences using their meanings, and then write what the underlined homographs in the following sentences mean. So here they've given you homographs, and you have to write them what the meaning of that word. How is it used? Now, for example, the first one is, a bear is an omnivorous animal. A bear meaning they're referring to the animal, which is a bear. And the second statement is, she could not bear the injustice. Matlab bear, yeah, here the meaning of bear is, she could not, matlab wo sahan nahi kar paayi. She could not bear the injustice. Okay, so similarly, you have to write the meanings of all the homographs here. And then you have to move on to your English workshop, where the first exercise is to read the text and fill in the flowchart of the promotions received by Arjun Singh. You can find it in this video as well, in the bulletin points that I had mentioned. And you have to fill in these boxes. Then the second one is, with the help of the facts given in the text, you have to prepare a fact file. His date of birth, place of birth, education. You can easily find all of these information in the chapter. Now the third one is, fill in the web. So you have to look for qualities of Arjun Singh, which are also mentioned in the chapter. As you will go through the chapter, you will get these, and you have to fill in the web. Then question number four is that you have to write what are the actions that led Arjun Singh to become in his career, to get these promotions. Now, for example, selected for Empire Pilot Training Course at RAF. Why was he, after what happened that led to his selection for the Empire Pilot Training Course at RAF? You have to find that and write it down. Similarly, for all the other questions. Now, the fifth one is, replace the underlined phrases with the appropriate ones to retain the proper meaning. Okay, so here they have used a phrase, but you have to remove that phrase and use the phrases given in the bracket, which is the most appropriate one. These phrases have been discussed in the chapter, so you can go through the chapter and you will be easily able to identify which one to put where. So for example, the first one, he contributed notably in bringing up the school. That means he made some contribution. So the appropriate phrase would be, he played a major role in bringing up the school. Okay, so similarly, you have to replace all the other statements and phrases. Then you have to build the word wall with the words related with military. These words also you will be able to find in the chapter itself. Now question number 7 again is about homophones. They have given you homophones and you have to write the meaning of that homophone word, and then you have to make a sentence of using that homophone, and then an exercise on homograph. Again, you have to, they've given you words which are homographs. You have to make two different sentences using the two different meanings of that word. Okay, and then you have to, question number 9 is, develop a story suitable to the conclusion or end given below. Suggest a suitable title. You have to write a story whose ending should be, and so with tears of joy and pride, the 10-year-old Sayogita More received the National Bravery Award from the Prime Minister. So obviously the person, the character in the story would be Sayogita More, and you can write anything that you wish to write. We wish to form a story which would lead Sayogita More to win the National Bravery Award from the Prime Minister. So you have to make a story and you have to give it a title as well. And that's it. Okay. Thank you.